TF2 has innovated many things, but one of the most notable innovations is an economy. It's truly incredible what Valve has created, virtual items for real cash. While this on its own was revolutionary, one aspect outshined all the others. Crates.
First we pitch them Disney, AT&T, IBM, blue chip stocks exclusive. Companies these people know. Once we've suckered them in, we unload the dog shit. The pink sheets, the penny stocks, where we make the money.
The unusual is the end-all be-all of trading. It's what every trader wants. The value it holds is not just in its looks, but its rarity. To obtain an unusual, you would either need to spend hundreds of dollars unboxing or trade for one. Choosing the latter is actually quite simple. You just have to go to a website like Backpack.tf and buy it. But much like the base game, it's been invaded with bots. No matter which item you're looking for, there's one either buying or selling. On the surface, these bots are not harmful and make trading quite convenient. However, the way these bots make money is by buying and selling with extremely tight profit margins. The amount of profit from these trades isn't worth it for a human trader, but since the bots are constantly trading with hundreds of listings, they are able to add up all the money they generate into a large pool. This manipulation into competitive pricing isn't just seen in trades, but also the Steam community market. All it takes is one YouTuber to completely inflate the price of one item.
The real question is this: was all this legal? Absolutely fucking not.
Despite most of the bans from this event being lifted, it shows the fragility of the market. Just one little fuck-up can change everything, much like it did in 2019. What's known today as the Crate Depression.
They called it Black Monday. No shit. By 4 p.m., the market had dropped 508 points, the biggest plummet since the crash of 29.
A 100% unusual drop rate. No longer were they worth hundreds of dollars, now only a few quarters. Luckily, Valve was able to somewhat return the market to what it was by making the first unusual you unboxed tradable. Most of the problems I've mentioned could be translated in a way to the real world, much like the standardized currency of metal and keys. The price of refined metal has dropped off drastically from what it was before due to the theoretical infinite supply of it. All it took was some time for it to be a few pennies. But what about keys? Their value is directly tied to the dollar. This in theory means its value would never change, but you can still buy keys cheaper from the community market than from Valve. TF2's economy is nothing short of remarkable, an innovation that has stood the test of time, much like the game it came from. Despite its many flaws, this virtual economy has given us something to study and has provided us with insight into why our economy works the way it does.
What kind of hooker takes credit cards?